Hi kids, welcome to today's lesson. In this series, we're going to learn about the early church, the apostles, and the power of the Holy Spirit. We're going to start by singing a song with Miss Sabina. She'll teach you the actions, but before we do that, we have to do some stretches together. So if you're sitting down, shake those hands and shake those legs, and let's get ready to join Miss Sabina.
Hello!
How are you guys doing today? So excited. We're gonna do some more workouts.
Yeah, can we get some ice cream?
Sure, let's start with ice cream. Okay, reach, grab that ice cream.
The bowl. Spoons, whipped cream.
Don't forget the cherry on top. Oh, the cherry on top. Maybe some sprinkles. Got lots of ice cream. Oh, I'm all sticky now. We need to wash our hands.
Okay.
Okay, but wash your hands. Wash, wash, wash.
Soap.
Wash way up high. Wash way up high. Wash all the way down low. And there we go. Dry them off. Oh, man, I'm so excited. I had so much ice cream. Can we spin?
Yeah.
Let's spin. Oh, so much ice cream. Oh, oh no. Oh. Hello everyone, so good to see you. I want to teach you guys one of my favorite worship songs, but first I want to explain something real quick. Quick little science lesson. Do you guys know how diamonds are made? When you have a certain type of rock and it undergoes a lot of pressure, that means everything around it is pushing really hard. Try and push your hands together really tight. Well, not too tight, you don't want to hurt yourself. But when certain rocks go under so much pressure, it probably hurts a lot, but after a while, they come out as a sparkly diamond. And so this song, we're gonna be singing about diamonds, but we're not talking about actual diamonds. We're gonna be talking about us and how when life is hard, when things are really tricky and we're struggling, things aren't going well, that's a good reminder that God is working in us, and it's like He's turning us from just an ordinary rock into a precious diamond. And that's what this song is going to remind us. So, let's sing together.
Here and now I'm in the fire and above my head. Whoa, being held under the pressure, don't know what'll be left.
Thanks for joining me today. I look forward to seeing you guys next week.
Wow, that was so much fun. Good job, everyone. Did you know that you can worship God anywhere? You can sing these songs to God while you're playing, doing homework, or before bed. With the right heart, anything we do can be worship to God. Do you remember what our memory verse is? Our memory verse is Acts 1:8. It says, "But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses everywhere." Acts 1:8. Now, let's watch our memory verse song together. Spirit is the helper from God who gives us strength and helps us make the right choices. With the Holy Spirit in our hearts, we can do so much. Now we're going to watch our Bible story so we can learn more about God and the early church. In this lesson, you will learn about Priscilla and Aquila. Let's watch!
Slapstick Theater. Aquila and Priscilla. This is Aquila.
Heyo!
Who was a Jewish man who was married to Priscilla. They lived in Italy until Claudius Caesar forced all of the Jews to move out of Rome.
Get out of here.
So they went to live in Corinth. There, they worked as tent makers and met Paul.
Oh, hey!
Who told people about Jesus.
Hey, come on!
Paul lived and worked with Aquila and Priscilla while he was in Corinth, telling people about Jesus. Aquila and Priscilla went on a trip with Paul to the port of Ephesus.
Wait, see you in a bit.
While they were in Ephesus, they heard a man preaching named Apollos.
That's me.
Hey, wait up!
Huh?
And taught him more about God.
Oh, all right.
They remained friends with Paul.
Yeah!
And helped him in his mission to tell people about Jesus.
Hey, thanks for that.
They once even risked their lives for Paul.
Oh, thanks for that too.
When Aquila and Priscilla went back to Corinth, they gathered people to their home for church. Paul told the people in a letter that he was thankful for Aquila and Priscilla and their service to the church.
Wow, Paul traveled all over to share Jesus and in the city of Corinth. God gave him great friends, and they were Priscilla and Aquila. Paul worked with them for a year and a half sharing Jesus. He taught them more and more about Jesus. They then shared what they knew to more and more people. Now we're going to watch a short video to Miss Alyssa, who is a part of our missions team here at CA Church. She's going to share some of her own experience of going to a place that has never heard the name of Jesus before. Let's take a listen.
Hi, everyone. Thank you for having me to Kids Church today. My name is Alyssa, and I work here at CA Church in our Global Missions Department. For those of you who are maybe a little unsure of what missions is, part of my job, and all of our jobs as Christians, is to share about the love of God with others. As I know most of you are aware, Jesus loved us so much that he was willing to pay a price for all the world's bad behavior, a price we could never pay ourselves. As Christians, we are so thankful Jesus did this, and even more thankful that we can live knowing he will always be there for us, no matter what problems we may face. Because of this, we want to share this news with others around us and all over the world. This is missions. I myself have been to many places in the world on missions trips, sharing about the good news of Jesus with others. Not only have I been able to share about who God is with people here, but I've also been able to share about him with people far away, in Mexico and in the Philippines. Some of you may be wondering, why is it important to share of our faith with others? Well, there are many reasons, but I believe there are two that are very important. First, have you ever received a gift, for example, something like a new bike, where you had wanted it for a really long time and just couldn't wait to share about how excited you were to receive it with others? That gift was so important to you, you couldn't help but to tell your friends. As Pastor Dora Lee will mention later, that is what the love of God is like. It is so important to us, we cannot help but to share it with others. Secondly, it is important to share about our faith with others because God's love for us is an answer to all of our problems. Have you ever hurt yourself and needed to go to a doctor? Let's say you broke your leg. Wouldn't it be strange if your mom or dad then took you to see, the mailman maybe instead? The Bible says that Jesus is like a great physician or a great doctor. He is the one who is truly able to heal all of our problems and hurts. If you and I know friends who are suffering or hurting, we want to help them to feel better and make sure they know the one who can truly help them, right? Because of these reasons, this is why I have traveled many times to other faraway countries to share about what God has done for us. However, as you can imagine, sometimes sharing about God in different countries can be difficult. For example, did you know that for a long time, I used to travel to an area in the mountains of Mexico where children who lived there had never heard about love? They did not have a word for love in their language. Can you imagine? On top of that, we were also not able to speak the same language. I spoke English and these children spoke Tarahumaran. So as you can imagine, at first it almost felt impossible to explain about God's love to them. However, what I've learned is that sometimes we have to be patient. Sometimes people don't understand us or they don't always want to listen to us right away, but taking the time to be available for others, showing God's love with our actions, and then explaining what we know, just like we read about in Acts, can be very impactful. In the case of the children in Mexico, we were able to find wonderful friends who were able to help translate and explain what we were saying in English to the children in their language. Since then, the kids have also been attending school and learning Spanish. Before, a lot of the children had a hard time smiling or being able to play. But now, after learning about a God who loves and cares for them, they are also able to love and care for others. They know joy. So boys and girls, I am wondering if there's anyone you can think of right now who lives near to you that has maybe never heard of God. Maybe they're a bit different from you, or maybe they too don't seem very joyful, or maybe they are struggling and need help. Perhaps you can discuss with your parents or siblings ways in which you can have the time and patience to share about Jesus with them. Well, I want to thank you for listening to me today, and I look forward to hearing all about your missions experiences. Bye for now.
Wow, thank you, Miss Alyssa, for your stories. When we love something a lot, we can't help but share it with others. Has there ever been something you've been really excited about that you just couldn't wait to tell others? What about a fun new toy that you just got? Or maybe you had a really fun birthday party? Or what about a new baby brother or sister? Whatever we're excited about, we just can't help but share about them. And just like how excited we feel about those things, we can do the same about sharing God's love for us. God loves you so, so much. And he also loves your neighbors and friends. What are some ways that you can share the love of Jesus with others? Well, we're close to the end of our lesson today. If you have your Bibles, your journals, your workbook, go and grab them. And here are some questions for you. And go ahead and write in your journals to reflect on our lesson today and what God is speaking to you. And if you also have your fun activity sheets, go ahead and go grab them. Is there something in your life that you were really excited to share others about?
Here and now, I'm in the fire and above my head. Being held under the pressure, don't know what'll be left.
Is there someone in your life that you would like to know Jesus?
But it's here in the ashes, I'm finding treasure.
And did you know that the adults are learning about friendship and what it means to be a friend? Share your experiences with your friends. Thank you for joining us. See you next week.